was a big day the day I got on that Santa Fe Limited, this California Limited, free and happy, you know. But I'd failed. And I think it's important to have a good hard failure when you're young. I came to Hollywood, there was just one thing I wanted to do. I wanted to get into the motion picture business. I wanted to be a director. That was my ambition, my goal, be a director. That was always my feeling, get in. Not choose, but get in. Be a part of it and then move up. What the hell, sweep the floor? I don't care, you know?
Woman she met, a friend of Hazel's, said, you know, I can get you a job. There's a young guy down the street who's making cartoons. But he had a little car, and he would drive mother and another young woman that worked for him then home every evening. And
Mickey Mouse, to me, is a symbol of independence. He was a means to an end. He popped out of my mind onto a drawing pad 20 years ago on a train ride from Manhattan to Hollywood at a time when the business fortunes of my brother Roy and myself were at lowest ebb and disaster seemed right around the corner.
Thank you. then we used to put the sound on afterwards, and in those days you couldn't do what we call dubbing today, where you could mix a lot of tracks. It wasn't yet science that you could get away with, so we used to have to do everything at one time. And we used to have to run the cartoon. We'd have the fellas with the sound effects, we had the people with the voices, we had the orchestra going, and everybody had to synchronize.
And playing with music and doing things with music was intriguing and everything. So I started the Silly Symphony, and I made the first one, and I called it the Skeleton Dance.
Thank you.